Hi, today we're going to show you the feedback circuit we've set up for the MIDIbox ASIDITY. So, just you guys get to have a look at it. The way it works is the audio output of the SID is going two places. It's going out to the speakers, and it's also going out into a digital volume control, which I can control by this knob on the keyboard. And then from there it's going into an amplifier, which amplifies the sound by 3 times, and then into a pair of LEDs, which are acting, in this case, as our limiters. So they will light up whenever the sound clips. You'll get to see that in just a second. We believe the clipping voltage of these LEDs is about 2.1 volts. So I guess now Soren will take you over there and show you the SIDs in action, or the SID in action. There are two options that you have to have the feedback running through the filter or just going back out of the audio output and back into the input without going through the filter at all. So here's what it sounds like without going through the filter. This is the technique we used in that opening sound you heard. So that just makes the sound a little louder, a lot thicker, and it gives you that weird bass thing that I guess comes out of the internal noise from the SID being fed back. Then you have the option to run the feedback through the filter. And basically what that does is it gives you kind of a resonance effect and actually enhances the resonance of the SID's internal filter. So you can see it brings out some of the high frequencies, and if you use that with cutoff and resonance, it kind of improves the filter. So you can see the resonance is a lot nicer there. Another thing you can use feedback for is to improve the harmonic distortion, which is natural and inherent to the SID's faulty or not filter, depending on how you like it. So without feedback, you get some nice distortion, especially when you're using the filter. But with the feedback, you can really take that distortion to the next level. Okay. Okay, here's a demonstration of the pulse wave in combination with the feedback loop we've created. So this dial is changing the width of the pulse wave. Right in the middle, it's set to a square. You should get these different harmonics as you go through it. So let's tweak the sound a little bit. Okay, here's what it's sounding like with the square or pulse wave and the saw wave on at the same time. Without the feedback, you get some pretty crazy stuff already in the high registers. Weird stuff going on, but when you add the feedback, well, it just gets crazier. So let's see.